Welcome to another little online art video with studionAme and me, Jonjo Elliott, just in case. I wanted to make this video about what inspires me. I get asked all the time, you know, main question, where do you get your inspiration? Where do you find the ideas? Where do your ideas come from? That's what I get asked. Where do your ideas come from? And I think for me, I'm inspired and I'm influenced by everything that surrounds me. You know, I look at different things that are happening, news.
Hello, sir.
Music, social media.
The Kirkland Facebook is open on my desktop and some of these people have pretty horrendous Facebook pics.
Everything, it all comes into it. And then I take those things, think about them, and it just comes out, you know. It's a sort of process of digesting and then getting it out onto a canvas. This is work in progress at the minute. So this piece is all about skateboarding, 90s influence, skate graphics, skate deck design, the skaters. The music of the time. This one's gonna have probably another 3 or 4 layers. And it'll all relate to that old 90s skateboard influence, which was a big part of my life, you know. This piece, the rose, which I've just newly finished, that's more about what painting can be and the process behind it. You know, it's a lot to do with the environment that we live in at the minute and the way it's changing. It's also about what a painting can be. So that for me is quite, you know, I quite like this piece, I'm into it. So yeah, getting back to the skateboard influence, you know, that was a big part of my life, sort of 20 years skateboarding. And I did an exhibition at LCB Depot in Leicester. Big shout out to LCB Depot. They sort of give us the space every year and let us do whatever we want through studionAme, which is brilliant. And I did an exhibition there, which was all about the way that I used to skateboard streets. You know, I'd go around skating the streets with my friends. But then to make this new exhibition, or the skate exhibition, I walked the streets of Leicester and I looked at marks and scuffs and scratches that were, you know, sort of on the walls, on the floor, wherever. And I took those things, kept them in here, and then when I got back to the studio, that influence would come out on the canvases. And I made a series of big abstract pieces for that. But then as part of the exhibition, I also built a working skate park, which became, you know, sort of the main feature of it. And on the opening night, we had a big skate session. So, as an artist, another thing you should do, if you want your work to fit into that contemporary sort of section of the art world, or if you want it to fit into the landscape world, or if you want it to be in the abstract world or whatever, you as an artist need to research what's going on out there, art history, be influenced by what you see, you know, other artists doing, exhibitions, visit exhibitions, go to shows, see what's happening, support your sort of peer group of artists, make sure you go to their exhibitions, see what they're up to, and also read books.
Looks like we got ourselves a reader.
Online is brilliant, but I like a book, yeah? So, you know, Jonas Wood, amazing artist. He's just released this book through Faden. And it's got 3 sort of essays in it about what the guy does. You know, his history, where he came from, what he does now, what he's into. And this sort of thing gives you an insight into, you know, what an art studio should be, what it should look like, what should happen in there. It's not an instruction manual. It's not supposed to tell you how to be an artist or how to, you know, certainly don't get this and copy what he's doing. Do your own thing. You know, stand out from the crowd, make something that's different. Everyone wants to see something different. So in collecting books, you can be always looking at what other artists have done or what they're into or what inspired them. Jasper Johns, flag. Search it out and check it. Pop art, have a look. if that's what you're into. You know, everyone is into a different sort of art, and that's what makes the art world cool, is the fact that you don't all have to be the same. We don't all have to paint, draw, sketch, whatever, do the same thing. We can all make art that's unique. Make it your own thing. Again, you know, yellow and green brush strokes, Roy Lichtenstein, look at that. Yeah? Go and search it. In fact, I'm gonna give you some names. David Hockney, you've gotta look at Hockney. One of our greatest British artists. Go and check him out. That's something that needs to be researched, okay? See what inspired him, see what led him to make what he made. Peter Blake as well, the same. Go and have a look. Use all that inspiration. You need to check things out, you know. Painting Today, again, another Faden, but they do some good art books. Just skipping through this, there's so much inspiration to look at. Again, don't go in there and copy it. Look at this work. Now, this can all be found online as well. You don't necessarily have to buy the book. But if you can find something that gets you thinking, you know, gets you interested, gets you making work, that's the main thing. Find that inspiration and run with it. You know, I've always loved Warhol.
Ladies and gentlemen, certainly a man who needs no introduction anywhere, of course, in the greater New York area and certainly around the country watching at this point in time. We saw you earlier. Andy Warhol, your impressions of what took place earlier on here.
Oh, I'm speechless.
I think Warhol was one of the best artists who ever was. A lot of people don't like him. A lot of people love him. That's what makes him a good artist. You know, I've always thought the whole Marmite thing, if your art makes people love or hate,
it's a tale of good and evil.
I've always liked that thing of having my own exhibition, going in there without anyone knowing who I am, and listening to what people say. You know, you gotta have broad shoulders, because sometimes it's not the best, but whatever. As long as you enjoy making your work, make it. But yeah, the whole thing of making art that people will either love or hate has always been interesting to me. You know, look at Warhol's work. He needs researching. Go and have a look.
Aka. Midori. Ao. Gunjoiro. Kyudei.
Imagine wo shigeki suru. DDK videotape.
One of the important things that you need to look at is what's already happened in art. You can't, I don't think personally that you can be, you know, a sort of contemporary artist today without having some sort of knowledge of what went on already. I'm not saying you've got to do a PhD in the history of art. All I mean is go and have a look. You know, this is sort of thing that hopefully, we're still teaching at school about the isms, the eras, the periods that people were creating different art styles in. You know, dead important. Have a look at it. Something like this, The Definitive Visual Guide of Art by Andrew Graham Dixon. That is an absolute massive book of the history of art. Now, I got this from a secondhand bookshop for like, hang on, £3. Okay, look at it. It's huge. £3. Go and get one. Have a look in the second-hand bookshops. There's loads of art books, man. But then inside there, there's every sort of era that's already been. You know, George Surratt, look at his work. Look at the style, check out the technique, see how they made the work, see what they did, you know, and if you want to borrow a bit of that for your influence, do it. Doesn't matter. You know, this goes all the way back to the sort of, I don't know when, you know, it's old, Roman civilization art. Dead interesting though when you look at it, because even today, Roman civilization, let's look at, sorry about the noise, Jonas Wood. So, hopefully, I'm going to be able to flip through this. And here we go. So, Roman civilization, all about ceramics, pots, vases. You know, what was on there? Ta-da! Look at Jonas Wood today. He's painting these big vases. He's doing it in his own style, yeah? But that whole thing of what's to say he's not been influenced by looking at that same book, that old art history book. You know, that whole thing of researching, look at these. Again. So you think about where you can find that influence taken on board. You know, for me, a massive, I can't work in my studio without music on. Anyone that's in the studio when I'm in there will know that I always have music blaring out. I love punk, indie, rock, pop, whatever. Anything that's feeding in and gets me moving, yeah? That's what you want. For me, that's a massive influence. For you, it could be symphony music and a glass of wine. Why not?
Dufresne, open this door! Turn that off!
For me, it's loud punk music and a cup of tea. Do you wanna make tea at the BBC? Yeah, rock and roll. So yeah, you find that thing, you research it, you look into it, and then you use it to get your inspiration, yeah? And it takes a while, you know, I've been painting for years now, and I'm still going between styles. I try and keep it all the same, but, you know, with this, what connects it? When you look at it, have a think yourself. I'm not gonna say anything. Bit of homework. What connects these two, apart from the fact that I painted it? You don't have to stick at a style. If you wanna skip about styles, do it. Make whatever you wanna make, and enjoy making it. Back to the broad shoulders. You're gonna make work at some point that people are gonna say, this is rubbish. What is this? Why have you done it?
They aren't always very nice.
It stinks. What's it all about? Whatever.
Why would God give me a gift to paint ugly and disturbing things?
As long as you enjoy making it, make it.
Why do you paint?
I paint. As a matter of fact, to stop thinking.
And enjoy making it, and then when you've made it, show it somewhere. Get an exhibition, put on a show, get it out there. Show people what you've done. You know, if you've got to set that up yourself, do it. No one's gonna do everything for you. You know, I'm with a couple of galleries now that do a lot of work for me, and they're great, they're brilliant. Coming up through the ranks, I had to do everything. I was in there at 11 o'clock at night, LCB, setting up that skate ramp on my own. Because if I didn't do it, no one's gonna do it. So it's a hard slog being an artist, but if you can do it, it's brilliant. You want to be an artist, get on with it. No one's going to do it for you. You know, there's going to be people that help you along your way, spaces such as LCB, Studio Name, that are going to give you some form of backing. Okay, maybe that'll be an exhibition, maybe it'll be funding so you can do something. Maybe it'll just be introductions, massively important. And use those things. But no one's gonna do it, man. No one's gonna hang that work for you. No one's gonna push it through until you're top of your game, right? So go for it and do it. And also, I'm lucky enough to be at Studio Name in Leicester, right? Which is a cool space to work in. I'm surrounded by some of the best artists in the UK at the minute. Contemporary artists that are making brilliant work. These guys talk all the time to each other. We chat about what we're doing. We share work. We talk about shows that are going on. We go and see shows. We do an art fair together, but not everyone can do that. It's not the easiest thing to do. So I started sitting at my kitchen table painting. You know, I went from there. And then luckily enough, I just got on with it and it led to something. But that's the only way you can do it. That is literally the only way you can do it. So go for it, use that inspiration, find your thing, make your art.